This week at the Internet Cafe, Cyber Chat. This is one cool chat room, a virtual meeting place in 3D called Active Worlds. Meet Meredith. You may have seen her chatting online. She runs the famous Concrete Cam using CU-SeeMe. The heavy chatters online are teenagers, and this is a talk site just for them. Meet Davey D. He's a rap disc jockey who runs a cool chat area called the Hip Hop Corner. Plus, a look at the latest twist on chat, instant messaging, at Excite.com. And Larry Magid joins us with some tips on chat room netiquette. Cyber Chat, this week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults.
Well, let's chat about chat.
Let's have a chitty chat.
Yes. Have you done online chat? You like
it? I've tried it.
Yeah.
I've tried it a whole bunch of times. I think the ones that I've been going to haven't been so good because it's all this kind of clicky inside talk and little terms that I don't get, and I haven't been in the know.
So it puts you off.
Yeah.
And Andrew, you a chatter?
I like it. Yes, I do. I you have to really have some time. I mean,
right.
You have to be committed to doing it, but it's one of the most popular. Really,
that's
activities
for sure.
On the web, and
is it just for young people? You think?
No, yeah, I have an aunt. She gets on there at night, 4 hours.
4 hours a night.
Four hours a night she chats.
Tell her to get a life.
Yeah,
huh?
Well, this is her life.
All right, we're going to take a look at different kinds of chats. This should be fun. All right, Rick, you run ActiveWorlds.com, which I must say is about the best 3D chat world I've seen
online yet.
It is really cool. I want to ask you the basic question. You know, there's an argument on this whole subject.
Okay.
Is it worth the bandwidth to do all the vermal, all the 3D stuff? Why do you think that really makes a chat room better, to have avatars and, you know, physical metaphors?
Our worlds are no bigger than a typical website. So the download, the bandwidth actually isn't a problem. And it's so much more immersive. You're in there, you actually believe you're in a world rather than just getting information or JPEGs off a page somewhere.
But, I mean, does something come from actually seeing some avatar move around or having that... I mean, you think the reactions between people are different when you're in that 3D world?
Absolutely. It's so much more immersive, and the whole idea is you're sharing a space with other people on the internet. You can see them, you can build objects with them.
Yeah.
So it's a collective thing everybody agrees to.
All right, let's talk about the way your little world works, because it really is cool and the action's very smooth. Sort of describe how you navigate around there.
It's very easy. You use the keyboard. You just use your
cursor
arrow cursors.
Forward, back, left, right.
Page up and page down, make you look up, make you look down. Shift key lets you go through objects, and that's about it.
You have different views, right? You have sort of a third-person view and your first-person view.
Yeah,
in there.
And you can click on it, home or end on the keyboard. It either makes you in or out of your body.
And how do you interact with people once you meet them inside the world?
Same way you react in the real world.
Yeah?
Pretty much. What you do is you accept this. Use your keyboard because you typed it.
Right.
So you type your information, you enter it, and you get a reaction
but
from the other
people. But besides the talking, I mean, you have gesturing too inside your place, right?
Some of the gesturing is actually automatic.
Uh-huh.
And then there's other gestures, that kind of like the emoticon type things, that you can actually click a button on the screen and it will, you know, make a gesture or a dance. You can do the Macarena.
Now, what's also cool in your place, you can actually, like, build a house. I mean, move in. This is like real space in a way, isn't it?
Oh, it's absolutely. Very much so like it.
So, I mean, what do people do there?
People do just about anything they do in real life, they do in Active Worlds. They meet
like,
people. I know several people who've gotten married in Active Worlds.
Now, I heard that. Is that actually true? I mean, people can conduct a wedding in your Active World space?
Yes, actually, it is true. And somebody asked me to officiate. They feel that I'm the president of Circle of Fire, thereby I'm the president of the virtual universe.
Active Worlds.
Yeah.
Any other stories? I mean, people really meet like they would in other chat rooms here and get to know each other?
Oh, yes. In fact, more so.
And what? Why is it more so?
Well, because there's something that they can do together. They don't just talk in a little chat room and then they leave. They actually have this community they've formed. People build cities. They build whole worlds together.
Well, you've got, what, 225 or something places you can go to in Active Worlds?
There are over 500 worlds
running
right now. Most of them are running on individuals' machines, people's PCs at home. When they
log
on.
So you create your own world, actually. And you end up being sort of like a little mini server where people can go to your world?
Yeah. Yeah, we operate, Circle of Fire operates this Uniserver.
Huh.
And the Uniserver allows all these little servers to connect up to it, kind of peer-to-peer.
People use avatars, right? Where do the avatars come from, and how much control do I have in designing what I'm going to look like in active worlds?
Well, the avatars are available for many different worlds. Many people leave them open so anybody can come in and get them. But really, the world owner is the one who would set the avatar configuration of that world. In the very near future, we're going to open it up so anybody can transmit it from a website. So you can have your own avatar. You can have Stewart avatar.
Where do we go next in these 3D chat worlds?
Well, the way we go next, we have to possibly integrate sound so that people could actually
really
have voice text instead of the text chat. That might make it a little more immersive.
But you do have music and sound effects, which I really like now. And you hear the birds chirping and all that stuff.
Yeah, that's nice. So we put that in and serve it over the web.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Conversation about chatting on the web I don't think would be complete without talking about sort of an early form of video conferencing, if you will. Meredith, Concrete, I think it's the handle you go by online.
Right.
You have a site, Concrete Cam, and you're really into CU-SeeMe technology.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're even kind of a little bit of a CUC celebrity. What is CUC technology?
It's video conferencing plus chat. And people use cameras and basically chat with each other while they're on camera.
Okay, so it's a streaming video image coming over the web. How fast is that actually refreshing? You know, how many images do people see a minute or a second?
Well, it depends on what your connection is. If you have a slow connection, it's only probably a picture every 10 seconds. But if you're on a fast connection like ISDN, it's about a picture per second, so it's pretty fast.
Really? So it's not like TV video quality, but it's still refreshing fairly rapidly.
Right, you can see enough.
Right, right. Now, is this something that more than one person can do it, two people can do it at a time? Can a group get online all together?
Oh, you can do either. I mean, usually people get on reflectors all together, or you can do it separately, independently with like one person.
So a reflector is like a hub or something where people, all the images come
together?
Like
a channel where...
Right. What do you need at home to actually do this?
Just a computer, the software, and a camera. Well, you don't need the camera, but it's best to have a camera.
Right. Otherwise, you couldn't send out your image.
Yeah.
Okay. So now you've got the camera at home. You're set up, ready to go. You've kind of become a celebrity at this, or I'd say it changed your life anyway. How has it affected you?
Well, I've met a lot of really, really great friends on CU-SeeMe. Most of my best friends are from CU, actually.
Really?
Yeah, I've been on it so long, and I've known them for so long. It's just like I met them in real life. But
now, you don't seem that old to me, so how long is so long?
Oh, a couple of years.
Okay, which in internet time is actually pretty long.
Yeah, right? I mean, people don't usually believe I've been on for that long, but
I have. Yeah, and then I looked at your site. You actually have some of your friends listed on there, people that you've met with. Now, have you... met these people? Have you traveled to go see them?
Most of the people on my site I have met, and most of them I've met from CU. I moved from Chicago to LA to basically be with a person I met on CU.
Really?
So
wow.
It has changed my life in many ways.
Yeah. Now, do you feel that it's different than chatting just with text? I mean, was there something that maybe made these friendships stronger that...
Yeah, you can definitely, it's more intimate with the people. You basically, it's just better, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
And you become to know the people a lot more.
Right. Is it sort of like people can't really hide the persona as much as if you're just chatting in text, you can sort of be anybody you want. But if you're CU-SeeMe, you kind of have to.
Yeah, people are a lot more honest. I mean, you know who they are. You're looking at them. You know they're not like a guy isn't a woman or a woman isn't a man.
Right.
So it's a lot better in that respect.
Right. And it's not really a voyeuristic thing, is it? It's more just people being honest, being out there.
I think it's just people chatting and having fun.
Right.
And it's not so much voyeurism as just getting to know people.
Right. Okay. Well, thanks. We're going to check out CU-SeeMe.
Thank you.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
So Annie, as the producer of The Insight,
you're focused on teen chat and a whole bunch of other things. Tell me a little bit about Insight.
Well, the Insight's a place for teens who want to make a difference in the world, and a lot of them have the idea that one person alone can't do it. So I put together a place for people of like mind to come together and be mentored in a way by adults who are already involved in all aspects of the process of making the world a better place.
So now at Insight, there's actually more than just chat, but it is predominantly a chat site?
Well, it's a place that's got an incredible amount of programmed chat, much more than just the casual chat. I'm really proud of that. But there's also what reflects this chat programming is posted content around issues of relationships and health and social justice, environment, things like that.
So all that supports the chat activities
exactly
that are
right.
going on. Now, tell me, when you're managing a teen chat activity, what's the difference about managing a teen event as opposed to dealing with adults?
I think teens like to act out and test the standards of the community. Talk City, of which we are a neighborhood, has a community feel to it, and there are standards of behavior. And so when teens come in, they want to find out, what can I do right up to the line to push the edge? They will get kicked out if their language is abusive, if they're harassing people. And they like to find out what that is. I don't know if adults do that as much.
Well, I've known a few to rant a little bit. So now, the types of topics that you're having, so today you've got how many different chats going on?
We have about 8 hours a day of hosted topical chats.
Okay.
And that's 7 days a week, in addition to being open 24 hours a day, so the other 16 hours of casual chat.
And so you actually invite people to come in and talk about a particular
issue.
Exactly.
That's my job as the executive producer, is to get in touch with experts who deal with youth services all across the board and have them come in and answer questions, which is wonderful because the kids are anonymous and they can ask questions of caring adults who they might not have those kind of people in their lives.
So oftentimes, you bring in adults who are experts on topics,
exactly.
And basically, so you've got really adult-moderated activity, but
yes.
It is driven by the teens.
That's exactly right. They're all teen issues. We have one really wonderful group where they have peer counseling, so the teens have been through a training program. It's about dating violence awareness and prevention. So the teens come online as the guests and talk to other teens about those kinds of things.
So now there's a lot of parents out there when it comes to chat and being online. There's a lot of talk about it being very addictive, very much escapism, that it's not a healthy experience. What's your comment on that?
I think it's healthy where we are, though I understand where they're coming from. There is an element of, hey, I don't have to go out and try to make friends. They're at my fingertips. But I tell kids online that there is a difference between an online relationship and a three-dimensional relationship. We are visual people as a species, and we are physical beings. And I think a lot of what they don't realize when they say, I'm in love with someone online, is that there are certain elements to a real relationship that is missing.
So you're working on helping them bridge the two different worlds together?
Yeah, we do a lot on conflict resolution, just making relationships better, which is a major issue for teens and adults.
So for those people out there who say, no, chat is not a good thing, it's not a healthy thing, your response is?
I think that moderated chat in the right community environment, an online community like Talk City's Insight, is a very positive thing. Though too much of anything I don't think is particularly good. So, a parent who cares might want to limit the amount of time on the computer.
That's great.
Well, we've got Larry Magid here again, syndicated columnist with the LA Times and contributing editor for Home PC Magazine. Larry, we're talking about chat on this show, and a lot of people have been online, surfed the web, done email, but never really been in a chat room. They see IRC maybe somewhere on their browser. How do you go to do a chat? What's the easiest way?
There's a number of ways. The easiest way is to go to a website that has chat, like Talk City, or many of the websites, even some of the news sites, will have news chats around a theme. If you're on AOL, of course, you can do the keyword chat or go into an area on AOL. Or you can do IRC, which is Internet Relay Chat, which is a little bit geekier because you've got to know some commands and it doesn't have the pretty interface that the web-based chats do.
Now, there's a certain protocol. Some people get intimidated. They'll go to the chat room, and these guys are talking with the emoticons and LOL and IMHO and all that stuff. Should you feel shy about just getting in on the conversation?
Well, you should get it. You shouldn't feel shy, but you should also be prepared for the possibility.
Because they can be pretty nasty.
Some people can be pretty rude. And, if they're rude, it says a lot more about them than it does about you. There are books or websites where you can find out what these emoticons
mean. Maybe do a little homework.
If it looks like a smiley face, it is a smiley face. But once you learn that, you'll get in there pretty quickly.
Last question, safety. Should you be concerned about giving out your name, your address, or something
like
that?
Yeah, anything you say in a chat, you're in public. Never got your real name, never got your address, your phone number. Kids have to be especially careful about what they do online. Yeah.
But chat's fun, right? People should try it.
It's a lot of fun. As long as you try to be safe, you're going to be fine.
Thanks, Larry.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cnptv.com.
When you think about chat topics on the net, you tend to think of what? Sort of trivial discussions between strangers, aliens, UFOs, sci-fi, a little bit of sex, conspiracy politics, but you don't tend to think about the hip-hop culture. Yet, what do you know? One of the best, biggest, richest chat sites on the web is all about rap music and the hip-hop scene. And DVD, this was all your idea.
How you doing?
You're a disc jockey here at KML in San Francisco. Mm-hmm. What was the idea behind putting up this site and getting people to talk about the hip-hop scene?
Well, I grew up on hip-hop in New York City. I was around when it first emerged, and as I grew older, I saw that it became a commodity that was being marketed by big business and falsely marketed, meaning that they were highlighting certain things. That,
like what?
Well, you know, the violent side of things, the negative side.
Kill the cops
business, all that.
Beat up the women type stuff.
Right, and hip-hop is such a rich culture, and the commercialization of it was something that a lot of people were starting to base their definition up on. Mm. So my thing was, I wanted to have a site that would become a primary source of information for people to start to build around. And since I had been around and I knew a lot of the people who first started this genre, I wanted to put that on there. Plus, you know, my whole thesis, and I'm a historian, so to speak, was based upon that. So I wanted to make sure that somebody who's real young, as well as somebody who wants to first find out about it, or somebody who's deeply into it, could come to a central place, and that's what we did.
Let's talk about the message boards that are up in your site, because that's one of the most interesting parts up there. I mean, it really goes on and on. Give us some of the different areas that the boards cover.
Well, we have maybe about four or five primary sites. There's a message board where people just talk generally about hip-hop, whatever the newest trends are, what their thoughts are on particular artists, the newest albums, et cetera, et cetera. That is pretty intense.
Yeah.
Then we have another section where it's called the freestyle board. And within hip-hop, a lot of people feel like they can rap themselves.
Right.
So we give people an opportunity to basically put their own rhymes up. And people actually battle. You know, they compete against one another and see who has the best rhymes, et cetera, et cetera. There's another part on the boards where it's a record review board, and we kind of designed this whole thing where you can categorize the music, where it comes from, whether it's good or bad, and this way anybody who wants to find out about a particular piece can find out about it.
I want to ask you, you said intensity, and man, that's the word for some of the dialogue that takes place in your chats. There is really this passionate feeling, a little bit about what you talked about, the commercialization versus sort of the real stuff, and the battle over the artist and who's good and who's bad.
Right.
Just give us a better feel for that.
Well, I mean, you're dealing with a genre of music that anybody feels, or a lot of people have opinions on. The music, it comes from different neighborhoods, so people want to express themselves, and the chats allow people an opportunity to express themselves and be heard and seen by people from all over the world.
Where does that passion come from? And people seem to feel so strongly, getting the real battles on you.
It's the classic battle between commercialization and art that is coming from a pure sense. So there's big business taking what they think we should be marketed towards and what we should be highlighting, and there's people that are creating it that's saying, no, this is my art and I want you to keep it this way.
Or seeing some of the artists they feel are copping out and just doing the commercial thing to make money and not sticking to the, the real thing.
So that's basically what the chats have really been, I guess, driven by is people's passion to really be seen and heard, and you don't often have that in the mainstream media.
Yeah, right. Now, good thing you've done there. It's a really good, the boards are easy to work with, the chats are easy to work with, it's easy to find where you're going. Was that sort of on purpose?
Yes. A lot of people, especially if you're talking about hip-hop, you're dealing with a lot of kids from quote-unquote the inner city, a lot of people who haven't necessarily been exposed to computers. I didn't want to make it complicated, and so we designed something that would allow people just to get on, plug in, and be introduced to cyberspace.
David E., thank you.
Thank you.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cnptv.com.
Joe, you're from Excite, and by some recent estimates I've seen, Excite is, I think, probably in the top 5 traffic sites on the web.
That's about right.
That's huge. I mean, that's a lot of people.
Thanks.
And I know that one of the things you guys do is, you know, sort of build community, try to attract people with, you know, interesting things to do. And I've seen this PAL, instant messaging. And it's sort of like a twist on email. It seems like a little more advanced,
right,
a little more live action.
Right.
Kind of tell me what your take on it is.
Sure. Well, generally, Excite is trying to build a community of its users, make people feel like and get in touch with other people that are on the service.
Okay.
It's a good way to help people feel like they're part of Excite, more like a member.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the services we offer is something called Excite Pal. And what that basically is it's a way for people to instantly communicate with one another. You download a small piece of software.
But isn't that email? I mean, instantly communicate?
The difference between email and PAL is the fact that email is like regular postal mail, where you send a message out and you hope that later on somebody gets it and then replies to you.
Right.
Well, the difference, what PAL is like a telephone. It's an instant way to communicate with one another.
Okay.
So PAL is to email like the telephone is to the postal mail.
Okay, okay.
That's the major difference, communicating instantly.
I can see that. Now, I was actually fooling around with it a little bit earlier, got online, downloaded the software, someone else was talking, you know, with me from across the, I don't know where they were actually, but you know, the green light went on and there they were. Now, is this something that is beyond chat? I mean, is this like people can use this in business, people can use this for...
Sure. The way to consider it is it's like private chat. It's a chat with you and your friends, or you and your coworkers.
Okay.
There's many ways of people use this application.
Mm-hmm.
So some companies have everybody in their company download it.
Really?
And then everybody puts their name into the pool, and you can see and send instant messages with one another or people in your company. There's a lot of personal uses as well.
Mm-hmm.
So for instance, I communicate with my father, who happens to live in Los Angeles, and I see him come online, we exchange a few couple of messages, and then he goes and does his thing, and I go do my thing. So it's both a personal and a business use.
Right, and so it takes sort of like browsing, which is a little bit of an individual experience, and in a way can add an interactive dimension, because you know other people are there potentially browsing with you. You can tell people to go to places.
And one of the best parts about it too is that it's free. It's like a free phone call.
Mm-hmm.
I'm chatting with my dad in Los Angeles. We're having a private communication instantaneously, and it's all free.
Now that's
And I can talk to my friends in Singapore. I can talk to my friends in London. And again, it's all free.
Now what if you wanted to do a group instant chat? Is that possible?
There is also a conference feature. So let's say you and I are chatting.
Right.
You happen to be in London. I happen to be in San Francisco. We're chatting with one another. We notice another friend that happens to come online. We can hit a conference button on PAL, on Excite PAL. What that does is conference that person, and now we have a three-way chat room going, or a four-way chat room.
Okay.
So effectively, you can take this from a telephone conversation point to point to a conference call with multiple people.
So it's almost like you could liken it to a pager system in a way as well. I mean, it's sort of like you're wearing a little pager while you're online. Other people know they can reach you.
That's exactly right. So you're alerting people that you're online, and then people can send you an instant message which pops up on your screen saying hello or asking you to join a conference.
Now, has there been any sort of strange or kind of funny things that maybe have happened with using PAL? Or do you have to sort of police people so that there's not...
I think the hardest part of that PAL has been getting people to start using it. What we've noticed is that people who download the product suddenly enter all their friends' names and then are a little bit confused when they don't see that their friends are online.
Oh,
so one of the things we've done is institute something called Dr. PAL.
Mm-hmm.
So when you come online, there's automatically somebody there waiting to talk to you, and that person's called Dr. PAL.
Wow.
And so what that is just getting people comfortable with the notion of having a conversation with somebody through this product.
Interesting. Well, I'm going to have to go online and see who Dr. PAL really is.
That's right. The mystery behind Dr. PAL.
Right. Thanks, Joe.
And thank you.
Well, Jane, did you discover any chats you might want to try again?
Yeah, I did. Insight. I thought that was a great site.
Why?
The moderated chats for teens and really topical topics for them to talk about. I really liked it.
This was moderated. That's the part you liked.
Well, I think so. And I think that there was good structure, and there's also really good, compelling topics that people could come together with. That was good.
You discover anything new?
Yeah, I like that chat is really expanding. It's no longer just, you know, sitting there and typing in words. I mean, you've got this instant messaging where you can actually really have a group experience chatting. And I like the cameras and CU-SeeMe, and it's bringing a whole video element into it. And I think video conferencing is, you know, here and at least right around the corner in a lot of
companies. What I liked about the chat thing, especially the hip-hop chat room I went into, I mean, I don't know a lot about the hip-hop scene, but what's
you do
really,
now.
I do now. That's right, because you can get into a conversation you might never otherwise get into.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't travel in those circles. I don't get to talk to those guys. But I did get to talk to them in this chat room, and, man, I learned a lot about what really goes on in that world. So I think the chat stuff is really cool. Anyhow, that's it on Chatting Online. We'll see you here next week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults. To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify the show number and the topic.